Namaskar and good morning. All my dear colleagues who are present on the dais, Sri Vaibhav Galleria, the Secretary of Higher and Technical Education, Government of Rajasthan, Sri Ravi Gupta, the CEO of Elites, Sri A.P. Mittal, who just now spoke, then my colleagues from Assam and Manipur, Mr. Gogoi and Mary Thomas, and my young, smart friend, Mr. Chandan, the wonderful team of Elites, the co-partners of the summit, all the lovers of education, innovators, young minds, I'm delighted to be here today. I'm not here as a chief guest or as an education minister. I'm here as a student. I want to educate myself. I have come to learn how we can make the place where we live in a better place. And I would request each and every one of you to listen, not to me, but to the speakers, not simply to hear, but to listen. Because the same moment is not going to come back twice again. We will not be able to get it tomorrow. So it is a great moment for us. As we were lighting the lamp, I was reminded of, and I was going through a small book, and I read a quotation from Swami Vivekananda. When he was a young child in a class, he stood up from a corner and asked his teacher, Guruji, Guruji, main ek sawal puch sakta hun aapko. Bola, kyun nahi aap you? Sir, is there anything called darkness? Is there, the question was, is there anything called darkness? And the teacher said, yes, why not? We have nights, we have darkness. There is a thing called darkness. But the child did not agree. He said, no, sir, you are wrong. You are not right. There is nothing called darkness. It's simply absence of light. He said, it is simply absence of light. So why we are today here? We want to remove the darkness from the world, from the earth, and from the country, and from the states. So we have to listen properly, because education is the only solution to the problems. Without proper education, no problem, no solution could be found to any problem. So, my dear colleagues, my dear friends, I've come here, I've learned a lot by, while I was seeing the exhibition, I learned many things which I thought can be applied and used in the state of Manipur. And my appeal to all of you is, the northeastern part of the country is also very much part of the great nation called India. Bharat Mahan Desh hai. Mahan Desh ka ek hissa hai. Aap log kuch log aaye honge. I think few of you would have visited, but many of you, majority of you would have not visited Manipur. So I extend you an open invitation to visit the northern part of the country and especially the state of Manipur where I belong to. As my colleague Mary Thomas said, the northeastern states are infested by insurgency. I was in police department as an IPS officer. In 1996, when I joined as a young officer, I was ambushed and I was hit by 7 bullets. And one of my colleagues, along with his 5 guards, were completely wiped out. And my vehicle was hit by 39 bullets. I survived, maybe because God wanted me to be with you. So I thank Almighty God. Now my point is, now insurgency is gone from the northeastern states. There is no law and order problem. So you please come and do some hand-holding, do some mentoring, invest, and also let us develop at the same rate like other parts of the country. That is my appeal, my request. Or my thank you so much. I became a little bit emotional. I used to visit lot many schools in a rural area. I'm just narrating about a story, a small story, because one of my friends was asking whether each and everyone was having this smartphone. No, smartphone. I was thinking, when we talk about technology and innovation, we thought, smartphone. Whether phones are smarter than us or we are smarter than the phones? Are we using the technology or technology is going to use us? Because when I look at all my colleagues here, all important people here, it looks like that you're all withdrawn or so disappointed. I want you to be smarter than a smartphone and to be energetic, because we have come here for some important summit, very important sector. We're going to discuss very, very important sector. So we have to be energetic, not withdrawn. Pura muh aisa tera karke baithne se thoda acha nahi lagta hai, kyunki hame bahut important ek sector jo education, shiksha ka bare mein hame discuss karne aaya hai. To energetic hona chahiye. Anyway, when we all are limited editions, the Almighty God had given limited time to each and every one of us. We have to go one day. When we go, whether we go to hell or heaven, we will go crying. We will not go smiling. So when we are not going, we are staying. Let us smile. What is harm? Why we are not smiling? And while clapping also, we as if we are very stingy, we don't clap, no? If we clap, jor se marenge, taali bajayenge, to hamara kya hota hai? Hamara, our health also improves. Nerves ke endings jo hai, scientifically, if you read health magazines, you'll find it. Jab hum pranam karta hai, taali marta hai, to hamara health ka wo acha ho jata hai. It improves your, you know, circulation. So clapping is a good exercise. So aapko benefit mil raha hai, phir bhi aap karna nahi chahte. So how you are going to educate children? How we are going to make education a better teaching system? To taali hamara bhashan na bajaye mat, jab kal ya aaj after my speech, if people come up here and speaks, please clap, let us motivate, encourage. That has not been happening. It's just as a formality it was happening, so I request all of you. Yeah, I come back to my that story. In a class, in a primary school, a teacher was teaching mathematics, addition and subtraction. Now, the teacher asks one of the students, primary class mein, bole aapka bag mein do apple dala hai. I put two apples in a bag, then another two apples in a bag. How many apples are there? He says five. Then again, if I take out two more, how many apples are there? Three apples. So I've given you four, you are saying that you have five apples. Then again, the teacher changed the question. If I give you two mangoes, do aam aapka bag mein dala hai, aur do dala hai, so how many mangoes are there? Four mangoes. If I take out, if you return two mangoes, how many mangoes are there? Two. Apple mein to bolta hai, panch rahega, aur do aur le jaega, tin rahega. Aur mango bolne se, char rahenge, if you put two and two, it'll be four. If you take out two, it'll be only two. Same question was asked to another student. She said, if you give me two apples, another two apples, and put in my bag, I'll have only four. Even if you give mango, orange, anything, four. So, aapka jawab galat hai. Then, teacher unko daantne laga. Then, the student started raising the hand and said, sir, already my mother put one apple in my bag. So, we, the teachers, the parents, we have stopped listening to our children. Only it has become one-way traffic system. That is how we have spoiled our children. We have not been able to make our children creative. innovative. We are talking about technology and innovation here. So that is why I requested, it's up to you. If you listen properly, not simply hear, and if you also think and think and think, you become innovators. So now, as I said, why we are here? We are here to make the great country a better place, the place where we live a better place. Whether we live in America, we live in Africa, we live in Manipur, whether we live in Bangalore, we have to make the place a better place. My dear friends, technology cannot replace the teachers. But technology in the hands of great teachers can transform the world. As I was doing round, there was one stall that is ultimate knowledge. They say they don't require, students won't require books nowadays. I really like the idea, because our young children, they have become a burden, carrying 8 kgs of books and exercise books on the shoulder and coming back. So they go at 8:30, come back at 3:30, and they become, education is a burden. So if no books, it's okay. But on the other side, now children have started, they have stopped dreaming. They have stopped reading books. If you don't make friends with good books, if you stop reading books, you are not going to grow. Why we educate? To give knowledge, to gain knowledge, to gain skill, and also to have critical thinking, analytical thinking. That is the purpose of education. So to get that, what we do? We have to make our children curious. Curiosity is number one. We have to make our young minds curious. Then we have to make them imaginative. Abhi kya hai? Cut and paste. If you are class 10 student, if you are given an assignment for 10 marks by your teachers, next to the college or school, you have so many shops with ready-made answers for your assignments. And at home, the mother and father keeps fighting for who will do the homework. Everything is ready-made. So how are you going to make our children innovative? So the purpose of education must be to ignite, to make children curious, make them curious, then to think imaginative. Then also, even if you are curious, if you are imaginative, if you don't have the willpower, nothing is going to happen. So we have to inculcate our children to be curious and to be imaginative, and also to have that willpower. When I was in school in 1982, I think, I was going through a magazine. I'm talking about willpower. There was a person called Niki Lauda, three-time Formula car champion. He was from Italy. I was going through the magazine. The subject was your secret of success. How you won third time the championship in Formula car rally. He said, he was narrating his story, the willpower. When my other competitors, when they meet with an accident, I used to press, the accelerator harder. When, just before he won the third championship, he met with an accident, all his face was gone, no hair. The doctors declared that he is dead. Mar gaya ye, bach nahi sakta hai, doctor bataya. He did not accept. He said, I'll live, I'll never die. His willpower was so strong. Then he went back, he had plastic surgery, he came back. When he came back, his wife did not recognize him because of the accident and plastic surgery. So it is the willpower. Unless you have technology, you have innovation, innovative ideas, so many five-star like classrooms, everything, but nothing is going to happen if the child is not curious, not imaginative, not doesn't have the willpower. So our role as a parent, as a teacher, is what we have to do. How we can, we have stopped allowing children to ask why, how, when, where, and what. When you start asking why, you become curious. How, you become imaginative. What, when. And we are talking about why we educate. Is it only to give jobs, government jobs? In India, we link education with getting jobs. Many of the students from my state, they end up becoming the peons and constables and the jawans, clerks. Sometimes many of the graduates, they do not know how to open an account in the bank. They do not know how to fill up forms for applying a job. Is it the quality of education? With all this technology we have been providing, I mean, my colleague from Rajasthan was telling, they have so many things. We don't have much in Manipur, but you see, this is the quality which we have been providing. So, I think you'll forgive me, it is an insult to all of us, including myself. We must produce young minds who are not job seekers, who will be job providers, like elites. The other day I was going through the Bhujia Baron from Rajasthan, Haldiram. If you go through his life history, it's so interesting. He started his business with just his 8th class pass. Now he has his business all over the world. Not only in India, not only in Bikaner or Kolkata. All over the world, globe. He just started with 100 rupees. And now his turnover is 5,000 crore, equivalent to the McDonald's turnover plus Domino's. You see, 8th class pass. And he can, now he's providing jobs to so many people. This is all about innovation, all about curiosity, all about willpower, all about imagination. Now, on the other hand, actually, I used to read small books. That is how, when I travel, otherwise I don't get time. No. It's not only the technology. Technology can be used to make our lives more meaningful, to make the place where we live in better place. But ideas like, for example, if you read about Charlie Chaplin, very tragic life he had. At the age of 14, his father expired because of cirrhosis. Mother had mental problem, was staying in a mental asylum. He was so poor, and he had to stay in an orphanage, which is the worst orphanage in the country. Then he thought, my life is tragedy. How can I make the lives of other people better? So he said, he thought, I can only make people laugh and smile. That is how he started. But whenever rain comes, he walks in the rain without an umbrella. Why? He says that, I just wanted to hide the tears. I don't like people to see my tears. So I walk in the rain without umbrella. When your tears come down, the rains will hide it. So he says, see, he can do wonders. He did wonders. He is known as King of Comedy. So my point is, why can't we make our children like Charlie Chaplin, Thomas Alva Edison, Michael Faraday, or Haldiram? We can make them. But the thing is, we have not been trying to do it. We ourselves were not curious, not imaginative. We didn't have the willpower. Hamara Bharat mein jab gurukul system ka education system chalta tha, that guru shisha parampara, the relationship is very important. When you love your profession, when you take interest, everything can happen. And many things are going to happen. But the thing is, do we take interest? Do we love our profession? Many of us, the teachers, the parents. Parents kya sochta hai? Acha school mein padha ko dal lene se hamara kaam khatam hai. Bachao ekdam automatic car, driverless car ban ke aa jayega. Hum sochte hain. Hamara burden khatam. Teacher sochta hai hamara jo padhana hai usko syllabus ko khatam karna hai. Uske baad hamara kaam khatam. Mark zyada aana hai kaisa bhi karke. Main easy de do, ye de do, wo de do, mark aana hai. Now we are here in the summit. Every year we have summits. World summit and many summits. We discuss. But what impact we have created after the summit? Have we seen any assessment, any change? Did we do some assessment? So my request would be, if one person can do wonders, many of us, we are a big team here, we can do wonders. But the thing is, we have to have the willpower, the determination. And we have to know very clearly what we want. There are many people who doesn't know what he or she wants. And who also doesn't know how to get what he or she wants. Many of the parents, if you ask them, why you send your children to the school or college? Because other parents are also sending their children. That is where we are sending. If you ask the students, why do you go to school or college? They will say that our friends are also going to the school. So exactly they do not know what is their vision, their dream. They do not know what they want. If you do not know what you want, how will you know how to get it also? A good leader, a good human being, should be able to know what he or she wants and how to get what he wants. So let us educate them, let us tutor them, coach our young minds. Let us use the technology. But the thing is, are we really converting our beautiful ideas, positive ideas into action? Transforming into action. I was just going through one of the findings of the study conducted by Information Technology and Innovative Foundation. They conducted study of 56 countries in the world, which makes up 90% of the economy of the world. And out of 56, India ranks in the 54th. Dear friends, we are living in a very exciting but very challenging world. We never knew, when we were a child, we never knew that we'll be able to have these smartphones. I'll be able to talk to my colleague in USA who is serving as a teacher. I never thought. So our young minds, we do not know what will be their future, in which environment they are going to work, what are the gadgets which they are going to use, and what are the problems they are going to encounter, we never know. So we have to prepare them for the future, which is unknown. And we have to make our young mind relevant. The magic word is relevance. If you have a degree, if you make a gazette, if you have the technology, but after some time it becomes useless, obsolete, no more relevant, then no point. So if we have to educate our children, they have to remain relevant for next so many years. I won't take much time. My request would be, let us work together, let us form a wonderful team, let us dedicate, let us have a determination, let us know what we want, and let us know how to get what we want. Let us use the gadgets, the technology which is available. And without technology, we cannot survive. But as I said in my opening remark, technology cannot replace the teachers and parents. But technology in the hands of great teachers and parents can transform the world. So let us try to transform, let us use, let all, us all of become great teachers and parents, let us take the technology in our hands and make this world a better place, and let us shape the future of our young people who are going to be our future. Thank you very much.